Hey everyone, and welcome to a new weekly vlog. It is Tuesday. I'm just leaving work, and I've just basically done a quick change because I'm off to see Elvis and the Royal Philharmonic Orchestra tonight. I am so excited for this. Priscilla Presley and Jerry Schilling will be on the stage. Those of you that know Elvis will know exactly who they are. As my boss just said to me, are you not fed up of Elvis yet? No, I am not. I am super, super, super excited. So we're here and we have got some amazing seats. The boy done good. Very good.
What you saw tonight and what you see here, for those who have not been to the show before, this is exactly the show that we would all see in the audience in Las Vegas when he would perform every night on his stay here. And Jerry will attest to this, is that when we watch this, it's emotional because we feel that we're there in that booth. Mr. Schilling, would you please come out? Please come out.
And of course, as you saw the TCB band who walked on stage, my God, the legendary TCB band. Gosh, this, like I said, it's a dream to have them here, and the first time that we've ever done this over here. And
it's like the old days, isn't
it? It is.
Being on tour with all this TCB band.
I know, that was just, yeah. Believe me, they deserve the biggest hand because they are the band that Elvis put together along with James Burton. I was just saying that when we watch this, it's as if we're sitting in the audience, you know, watching the from Vegas. I can't even talk. It's just emotional. And you get emotional,
yeah,
too.
I do. And it's as close as you can be, yeah, of being on tour with Elvis.
Yeah.
And Robin Smith with the orchestra.
Great.
Honey, my God.
Great.
What an honor. Dominic, everybody.
What do you mean?
Elvis would have loved this stage. What do you think?
Oh my God.
Okay, yeah.
Listen, all of you here from the UK, I know you're all from the UK, but it's just, being here is emotional for us because this is what he wanted, to be over here doing just a show and being in front of all of you, because this was a dream. And so I think that's why I get so emotional, is that, you know, just how you are, even you're stuck on watching him and you just can't stop. Well, we made it happen.
Well,
yes, yes.
You know, this lady did make it happen, I must tell you. And she's tired of me saying this. She did make it happen when all the execs and everybody else didn't really get the idea of Elvis and the Royal Philharmonic Orchestra. Yeah. And Don Lima, the producer, came to her and she took it from there. But wasn't there one thing now we didn't think about?
What?
That's the added mission, and that's these guys, the TCB band.
Yeah, exactly.
Let's talk to them.
For sure.
James Burton, Rock and Roll Hall of Fame.
For sure.
There's only two people I know. I only have two friends that have a statue. Elvis and James Burton.
Yes, his own statue. Nashville.
Who's Yeah. Shreveport, Louisiana.
Shreveport, Louisiana. I was there. So let me ask you something. What stood out? You played, of course, with all the greats in this business, trust me. Name a few for me. Audience.
Well, Frank Sinatra, Dean Martin, Sammy Davis Jr., Ray Charles. You're such a name dropper.
So
you can do it.
Let me ask you something that maybe all of us would like to know as well. Of course, I do know, but what stood out, you know, with Elvis compared to all the other entertainers that you have been?
Well,
the king?
Elvis, to me, is an incredible icon. The guy changed the world music. He changed it. Absolutely.
Would you say, like, when he walked into the room, you could feel the presence?
Absolutely, you could hear a pin drop.
It's true.
And there's one thing that Elvis would be very proud of that I don't know if everybody knows about James. James is one of the biggest humanitarians. Young kids, he's been doing charity work and giving away guitars to kids who couldn't get them.
That's true.
And
thank you, James. Thank you for being here. I'm Glenn.
Glenn D. Harden.
Well, what you don't know about Glenn is he not only is a wonderful pianist and Elvis loved this group that he put together, like you cannot believe they're the best of the best if you can find a trio like this. But what people may not know is that he did a lot of arranging on songs for Elvis, I believe 38, right? Can you just tell us a few of those, please?
Just Can't Help Believing, American Trilogy, How Great Thou Art.
Just to name a couple, I mean, major.
And just a little diversity. He also wrote songs for Dean Martin.
Yes, I did.
Elvis was a huge fan, right, Priscilla?
Oh,
of Dean Martin.
Yes, he
wrote songs for him. Besides arranging, I didn't know that until he walked on stage.
Oh my gosh, I feel, you know, we have to drag it out of these guys. They are the most humble of the people that I know as far as in the business. It's a rarity, but we want to brag on all you guys, so thank you.
Wendy.
Hello there, Ronnie Tuck. Ronnie Tuck is over.
Mr. Tuck, I gotta tell you, I just remembered tonight before walking on stage why you're such a damn good drummer. Because, you know what? At 8 years old, he was a tap dancer. True. You were a prodigy, right? Child prodigy, tap dancer?
So to speak.
Yeah, yeah. And went on to be speaking like the other TCB, like the other TCB.
No,
Jerry,
you're not going to sit down.
The other TCB band members. He has worked with everybody. Just finished, 30 something years with Neil Diamond. And truly, as all these guys, Elvis loved this guy. They not only drummed together, they had heavy talks together. And just, this is family up here, this TCB band.
Yeah, and you know, it was up to Ronnie to watch Elvis move on stage. So every time you saw Elvis lift up his hand, look over, bend over, whatever it was, he is here making sure that he gets every lick, gets every movement, and he had that report. I mean, literally, his eyes were glued on Elvis. I mean, and he captured everything, and Elvis loved it because he could do whatever he wanted, knowing that Ronnie was watching him. So, you know, you had a great rapport, you know, with him, and he just loved you. He just said, "Listen, he's my man. He knows what I'm going to do. He's going to capture it." So,
let's watch Ronnie and the TCB band.
Let's do it.
Let's get on with the show. Thank you, guys.
the intermission, and oh my word, what an amazing, amazing show. I'm just mesmerized. It could have been the real Elvis walking on stage, and I would not have had a better reaction. I've just been smiling all the way through. I tell you what, this is phenomenal, and I am so grateful to be here.
Just pretend I'm holding you and whispering things soft and low.
Bound to die.